So are you married?
Engaged.
You engaged? Okay, give me that. Hebrews 13:4. So you engaged to a sister, right? Okay. Praise. So this is what you gotta understand though, Hebrews 13:4.
Hebrews chapter 13, verse 4. Marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled. But whoremongers and adulterers God will judge.
So you hear that? Read it again.
Marriage is honorable in all.
Boyfriend and girlfriend.
Marriage is honorable in all.
Jump on.
Marriage is honorable in all.
Thought.
Marriage is honorable in all.
So God honors marriage between a man and a woman. That's what God honors. Read.
And the bed undefiled.
And your bed between you and your wife is undefiled, as long as it don't go against the laws of Leviticus, the 18th chapter. Read.
But whoremongers.
But what?
But whoremongers.
So brothers who out here chasing the skirt, as they say, or brothers out here running up trying to hit anything they see, women, men, whatever the case is, that's a whoremonger in God's eyes. Read.
And adulterers, God will judge.
So God will judge. God will judge you by sending plagues upon you. Herpes, gonorrhea, things like that. AIDS. Right. Marriage is honorable. So between you and your fiance, you have to marry this sister. Because why? Why is God, why are we out here teaching you that? We teaching you that because, I mean, just because we want to? No, we teach you that because the Bible says so. Give me 1 Corinthians 6:9. Because if you not marry this sister, I'm gonna be honest with you, bro. If you don't marry her and you having sex with her and sleeping with her, God calls that fornication. You understand what you understand that fornication? You understand what that means, right? What does that mean?
Oh,
fornication.
Right.
Without marriage, okay? And there's different levels of fornication, but we're talking about that one in particular because that's what we're going over, marriage. Read.
1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9. Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revelers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God.
Remember, who the kingdom of God for? The nation of Israel. Is it for the nation of Israel because we're saying it so? Or is that what the Bible, we just read out of the Bible? So if you in the nation of Israel and you in the midst of breaking or you in the midst of any of these things, he said you cannot inherit the kingdom of God. Read it again from the top.
Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God.
So it's talking about unrighteous man. Anybody that's out here, unrighteous man or woman, that's in the nation of Israel, shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Now it's going to give you the attributes on what makes somebody unrighteous. Read.
Be not deceived, neither fornicators.
Neither what?
Fornicators.
So if you sleeping with a sister and you're not married, we just read in Hebrews 13:4 that God honors that. That is honorable in the eyesight of God. But if you on the opposite end of that, God calls it fornication, and you can't get the kingdom of heaven. You understand that? So it's important that you take this sister and marry her and get papers. I don't know if you're sleeping with her or not. Are you? Are y'all having consensual sex? Y'all have a baby, right? So you're in the midst of fornication, bro. You understand that?
I'm trying to get married.
You trying to get married? What's stopping you?
I guess
so. Huh? Just broke? They got stuff set up where you can actually get your papers through the court system if you got like public assistance and so forth. You can get that stuff for free. And so it takes initiative. You got to take the initiative, especially since we're reading out of the words of God now, because now it's not personal. It's not a personal attack against you. God said you got to do that. You understand that? Read.
Nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind.
Nor effeminate. What does that mean? Effeminate means something that goes on rampant out here in Atlanta. Effeminate is talking about male acting like women. All right? You can't get the kingdom of heaven either. If you a man and you act like a woman, you got woman traits, God said no. The kingdom ain't for you either. Read.
Nor thieves. Nor effeminate. Nor abusers of themselves with mankind.
What is that talking about? Homosexuality. So if man having sex with another man, God says you can't get the kingdom of heaven. You understand that? Read.
Nor thieves.
Nor a thief. If you like to steal, you ain't, the kingdom of heaven ain't for you. You gotta imagine, the kingdom of heaven talks about us walking on gold roads. You understand that? It's gonna be so decked out to the point where it's crazy. We can't even fathom the thought. You think you're gonna be a thief when you get in the kingdom of heaven? You'll be trying to steal all type of stuff. God says you can't be that. Read.
Nor covetous.
Or a covetous spirit. Because a brother got something that you like and you can't, you ain't doing what, you know what I mean? You're not actually out there putting forth the work to get it, and you just want to steal, covet, hate. God says you can't get in the kingdom of heaven for that either. Read.
Nor drunkards.
Nor a brother that drunk, a drunkard. Alright? A brother that alcohol takes over his life. He gotta wake up, first thing he gotta do, he gotta hit the bottle. You understand? Things like that, God said, you are a drunkard and you can't get in the kingdom like that. You understand? Read.
Nor revelers.
Nor reveler, meaning you like to go clubbing. You know what I mean? Club to club to club, drinking, smoking and so forth. Read.
Nor extortioners.
Nor a brother who extort people out of their goods. Whether it be money, cars, clothes, anything of a value, and you extort somebody out of that, you can't get in the kingdom. Read.
Shall inherit the kingdom of God.
You understand that? So if you was in the midst of any of those things right now, today is the time for you to stop, brother. You understand that? Give me Acts 3:19. Hey, bro, how you doing today, brother? Bro, right there with the just walking past with the mask. Give me that Acts 3:19. So this is what God commands you to do right now, bro.
Acts chapter 3, verse 19.
Come on.
Repent ye therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out, when the times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord.
That it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we're gonna read it again from the top. Read.
Repent.
Do what?
Repent.
Do what?
Repent.
So you hear the message? You find out you was an Israelite, you finding out these ways on the customs or things that you must do, that you was walking contrary prior to today. God's telling you repent means to change from your ways. All right, read.
Repent ye therefore and be converted.
And do what?
And be converted.
And do what?
And be converted.
So give me Psalms 19:7. We're going to show you what converts a man, what converts a whoremonger into a man that take his sister up in marriage. What converts a drug dealer into a hard-working man that go to work a 9-to-5? You understand that? God, read. It's the Bible going to tell you.
Psalm chapter 19, verse 7. The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul.
So what converts your soul? The laws of the Lord. God's laws, like we're just going over, that's going to convert your soul. You understand that? Read. Go back to Acts. Now read it again from the top.
Acts chapter 3, verse 19.
Uh-huh.
Repent ye therefore and be converted.
By keeping thy laws. Read.
That your sins may be blotted out.
Meaning your sins will be blotted out by the Lord if you repent. That means take whatever you was doing, stop it. Now walk in the laws and the commandments of God, and God will blot your sins out. All right? Meaning to take them away, so to speak. All right? Read.
When the times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord.
The time of refreshing is talking about when the Lord returns. Remember, he's talking about saying you're going to be put to death. If you're in the midst of breaking the Sabbath day, when the Lord returns, you're getting put to death. That's the Lord refreshing the earth, all right? He's going to refresh the earth with how? With nuclear bombs. You understand that? You ever heard of that before? The earth is going to be destroyed with fire? You never heard that?
I've heard that.
Growing up? Nuclear fire. Did you know that was biblical? You didn't know that was biblical?
So the earth is going to be destroyed by fire, bro.
Alright? And that's what the time of refreshing is going into. You understand that? So when the Lord brings the boom on this place, all the evil going to stop. It's going to cease. Then the Lord going to establish the kingdom of heaven. The kingdom of heaven going to be established, and then we're going to walk in righteousness. Give me that Matthew 6:9 real quick when you hear the Lord's prayer. Matthew 6:9.
Matthew chapter 6, verse 9. After this manner therefore pray ye, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come.
So it says, like, our Father, read it again from the top.
After this manner therefore pray ye, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come.
So he said, your kingdom is going to come. You heard this prayer before? Everybody prayed this, but they don't, a lot of times they don't know what it's talking about. He said, your kingdom is going to come, God. Read.
Thy will be done.
The will of God is going to be done. The will, let's give him what the will is. It's going to, all, what you're going to find out, this Bible, it talks about the same thing over and over. Because our people, we tend to forget, so God always got to continue to remind us. All right, read that.
Psalm chapter 40, verse 8.
Come on.
I delight to do thy will, O my God.
Yep.
Yea, thy law is within my heart.
What is God's will?
Thy law is within my heart.
So what is God's will? The laws, all right? The laws is his will. So when you go back to the Lord's Prayer, it says, thy will be done. How? He got to bring refreshing, though. Is God's will being done? Look around you. Is the will of God being done? What's today? The seventh day. Are people supposed to buy and sell on the seventh day? No, it means the Lord's will not being done.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.